Okay, people, I know you've all been researching stories of the unexplained, but I actually want to start with one that goes back half a century. Brandon.
So this story I covered, I went to Knoxville, Tennessee, and I probably covered one of the more peculiar stories of multiple lifetimes.
Lots of people claim to have seen a UFO. Our reporter traveled to Tennessee to get to the bottom of the story.
And we've heard stories that your family has been, let's say the word, subject to a number of inexplicable events.
Well, we had a horse farm back in Massachusetts in the early 60s, and there were a series of accounts that involved UFOs, I guess, tabloid term. But my brother and I actually had seen them more than once, and actually at one point boarded one. We saw what looked like a silhouette, a glowing image, almost like a ghostly figure. The ground beneath us changed, and we went from a staircase to a field. And at that point, we started walking into this entrance area. There was this craft that looked like a huge turtle shell. My family kind of was tight-lipped about it, and it became more of a investigated behind the scenes and was taken to the UN in 1992, and after that, we were pretty quiet about it for several years.
I can see the reasonings why he does what he does. He's got a mission to show the world what happened to his family. His story is really not a story. I mean, he's got the facts to go behind it.
There are some people who would say that some of your experiences may be possibly embellished because it may become in a potential movie. What would you say about that?
I'd say there hasn't been any embellishing. I could tell you a lot more than I am, but I'm only sharing with you what's on this table.
What was on the table? I just saw a bunch of papers.
All right, what you're looking at on that table, you're looking at classified police reports, you're looking at medical records, you're looking at investigation reports.
Photos, though? I mean, decades of this, is there any...
All of that is mixed in there. You're looking at a lot of classified information that is sitting there on that table that backs his story.
This is an abduction. He said he boarded it. I mean... Yeah.
Brandon, I find it fascinating that we're talking about an entire family that has been plagued by UFO encounters. But is it too good to be true? Is it too Hollywood ready?
What we do know is that his story has been supported by a lot of reputable individuals, and I met with one.
Now, do you remember administering the poly test to Mr. Thomas Reed?
I do.
What questions did you ask, if you can remember any, some specific, not all of them, just a couple?
It was basically, was he lying to me about the contact he had back in the 60s?
What were your findings?
He was telling the truth.
That's a science.
It is a science.
Brandon, I mean, clearly it seems like you believe what this gentleman was saying, what our witness was saying, but a polygraph test, you can fake.
No, you can't, man. I have to meet with Jim Morris. I'm telling you, there's not much that you can do to really pass
if
a polygraph.
You believe
if you
that
believe
it's
it.
True. Yeah.
Several times.
You can fake
several
the
times.
Polygraph.
If you believe it.
Right.
And yeah. That's a great point.
So let's say you do it several times. All right. I did go in with a little edge of skepticism, but after seeing the classified documents, the police reports, the medical reports, the videos, meeting
you
with
believe
the
it? You believe it?
I'm sold.
Wow.